the Guru gives the teaching in the form of Atmajnana, Tattvamasi. Now, what is realization? Okay, realization is Shravana-Manana-Nidhidhyasa required or not? So, you have to understand the role of Shravana-Manana-Nidhidhyasa.
That is true. Adre being the next step, knowing is the first step. It's
no, knowing. Huh? Knowing is the last step.
It's ultimate.
Knowing is ultimate. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa are the three stages of Atmajnana. Shravana is listening. Adnana has to go. Who am I really? Adnana has to go. Now, where is the Adnana for you? Adnana is there because you learnt a lot of things from society. All society gives all sort of information. Ultimately, what your knowledge is? Society knowledge. Real knowledge is not there. Real knowledge is called Atmajnana, which will have to remove the ignorance of the self. That is called Jnana. Nothing more is possible. That much is possible only. Jnana is that much only.
Okay?
So if a very highly qualified student, if gets that much, is over. For him, nothing is required. There are three types of students. Okay, Uttama, Madhyama, Adama. The top quality, middle quality, and Madhyama, and Samanya. Adama, okay? Samanya. Uttama, Madhyama, Samanya. The Uttama, the quality of the top quality, is a Jiva which is already pure.
Just one word itself.
Just one word, Jnana, finished. Okay?
And he is Amel on being Agbirtana.
Agbirtana. Mugitavya. That's matter is over.
Yenu Nididhyasana,
yenu beda. That's for them, for the Veda Upanishad say, for him, Shravana Matrena Mukti. Shravana Matrena. Nothing else is required. Over. Okay, that's a very rare. Out of 1,000 people or lakh people.
Koti Gopan.
Koti Gopan. Very few people of that nature. So don't have to feel jealous, okay? Such people are not there. They are actually, but Vedas have to address rank student. What is rank student? They say rank student is Shravana Matra, finish.
But someday even Madhyama will become Uttama and only.
Yeah, she's hoping for that. So there's how it'll go.
Promotion
will happen.
No, but clearing. Uttama.
Yeah. So next level of people, next level, this is called Madhyama. So they have to go through Shravana and Manana is sufficient for them. They do Shravana and Manana. So then, most of the people like us, Nididhyasa is important. Actually, Adnana goes with Shravana and Manana only, with the clarity, with Vedanta teaching, with clarity will come. But what will happen is, lot of impressions are there, backlog. Okay? So, the impressions which are actually earlier, the strong impressions are there. The Uttama, the top quality student, what he has already cleared the impression before coming to the teaching. Okay? Yes, actually done is a past is what is that?
Yeah,
he has finished all his cleaning up and then come to the teaching. Whereas most of the people will go to the, first of all, we don't know such teaching exists. After coming to teaching, always something is there. Then you have to do the pending work, cleaning up. That's called Nididhyasa. So Nididhyasa, you have to go and clean up what is there stored earlier. It's called Vasanas, impressions. So again and again you have to do. It's called Nididhyasa, it's a different type of Samadhis. Savikalpa, Nirvikalpa, Savidarka, Savikalpa, Nirvikalpa, Samadhi, Bahya and Antara. So that will clean up. That's basically what is the pending backlog. Jnana is this much only, Shravana. But what happens is for most of the students, I will say 99%, Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa has to be repeatedly done to clear. Nididhyasa doesn't give mukti. Jnana gives the mukti. Nididhyasa is clearing the backlog, vasanas. You got it? See, for example, you get a clarity. Nanu nanembudu nanalla, I am not the body, my intellect. You got a clarity. But the moment you go to in front of the husband, okay, you become the boss.
All right?
That vasana will not go. So, the moment.
This was a test when you told you
to
become the boss.
Yeah, I'm telling the reality. So, everybody knows the secret. So, our vasanas will come up. Right? So, you start bossing around. You forgot, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not. And husband is also not body, I am not forgot. That's why you don't Nididhyasa. So any questions?
So every moment anta awakening every moment detached form idralle irutte.
See, for us, everything in life is a full-time activity. Correct? Is there a part-time activity? Eating food is a full-time activity. Morning you wake up, what is breakfast? Okay, 11 o'clock, what is the snack? 12 o'clock, afternoon, what is lunch? Okay, eating food is a full-time activity. 365 days a year, only no rest, no? Okay. And being a wife or husband is a full-time activity. Even dream also you'll be wife only. Okay? So, right? You are being a mother is a full-time activity. Being is employee at least a full-time activity till you get retired. Actually, nowadays companies want you to 24/7 actually. So even your house, their mobile phone and everything, they contact you. So in life, everything is full-time activity, but God is only part-time activity. How is it possible? It's a no-time activity. So 10 minutes, 15 minutes puja, over. How can it be possible, tell me?
He's not demanding.
God is the only one who is not demanding actually. He doesn't even command. Okay, he doesn't demand. It's your voluntary effort. That's where you need it. So, Shravana-Manana-Nidhidhyasa Atmajnana Sadhane is a 24/7 activity as full as your day-to-day life. But the only intelligence you have is how you integrate, that's all. It's not that you have to run away, it's a 24/7, I'll become a monk. No, that's not required. It's your skill, your intelligence. How you integrate into your daily life is your skill. Okay? There are many, many examples. Puranas are there to give you example of how to integrate in your life. Don't think that, spirituality is a full-time activity, I have to become a monk and all those things. Don't think that. As a householder, as a grahastha or a grahini, you can integrate spirituality into your life. In every aspect of your life. One thing is, you have to give a priority. It's not a part-time activity. Difficult. No, it's not difficult. It is a skill.
You're getting lost always.
You have to integrate into whatever activity you do, you have to integrate spirituality into that. Okay? Okay?
Actually, do
you don't do anything spiritually separate.
Now, spiritual and kutla, it's a different
Don't make it's compartmentalized.
Everything is
spiritual. Don't make spiritual life and material life separate. Everything you have to convert into spiritual. Yeah, every aspect. Right. Today I am going to give a talk. Next talk is going to how to make a life spiritual. Okay. So bring spirituality into every aspect of your life.
Yes.
Your whole life becomes spiritual. Don't confuse. There's a material life and spiritual life separate. There's only one life, divine life. It's a 24 hours life.
Every moment
you have to live in God consciousness. That's spiritual life. So right now you are every moment that same God consciousness you are converting material consciousness. Because there's only one consciousness, God. Too heavy? Any questions?
But turning inwards and self-inquiry is sort of related. Is it similar?
See, the question is, turning inwards and self-inquiry are related. See, the turning inwards, our attention is outwards in the objects. Okay. Our attention going to inwards is going towards the mind and intellect, inwards. So, knowing myself, knowing my mind, knowing my intellect, it's called swadhyaya, it's called inwards. You go first from outwards to you go to inwards and then you go beyond. The self-inquiry is to go beyond the mind. This is the third step. Okay, first step is inwards, you have to go inwards and then you have to go beyond. Self-inquiry takes you beyond the mind. It's not inwards actually, it's beyond the inwards. So, in Kannada, if I have to say, Bahya Mukha, outer face, okay, you can go antarmukha. Means inward. Inward is actually your meditation. All those things are inwards. But self-inquiry is not inwards, it's beyond. It's going beyond the mind. You okay? So, self-inquiry is not a mental activity. Self-inquiry is going beyond the mind. Most of the time, self-inquiry fails because it has become a mental activity.
People, it's a structured process. It's a structured process.
It's not a structured process. It's very, very simple process. But because we are cluttered in the mind, we are stuck in the mind. It's not a complex process. Self-inquiry, Ramana Maharshi, what self-inquiry is given, is a very, very simple and direct process. For an evolved sadhaka, it's just a matter of a straight, it's nothing complex. But for most of the people, it's they are cluttered, so much of clutter in the mind, the self-inquiry becomes a mental activity rather than the going beyond. Self-inquiry is very simple. It's not complicated. Okay, but to prepare the mind, there's a structure process required. Mind has to be prepared for self-inquiry. That's a structure process. That's what is the maturing of the mind. Self-inquiry per se is not complex.
Is it related to Shravana-Manana-Nidhidhyasa?
That's what I'm saying. This preparatory process is Shravana-Manana-Nidhyasa. Okay? Self-inquiry is the last stage. Of course, all these are for self-inquiry. But what happens is that, see, our mind is layers and layers of ignorance and vasanas are there. Okay? None of them are right understanding. They are all wrong understanding of life, including God, about God, spirituality, everything wrong understanding. That has to be uncluttered based on the teaching of Vedanta. Okay? That is Shravana Manana Nidhyasa. Then beyond that, there's a self-inquiry process which is called direct path. Okay? So typically, people who go through, this is called Jnanamarga. Shravana Manana Nidhyasa is Jnanamarga, which is a maturing process. And self-inquiry actually doesn't require this in reality. It can straight away go there. But the problem is the already so much of a clutter is there. That clutter requires a preparation.
Cleaning up.
Otherwise, self-inquiry is very simple, very direct process. That's what Ramana Maharshi says very clearly. It's for most very advanced souls.
Is there proper documentation of his self-inquiry?
I'm doing it. It's a lot of work. Of course, there are bits and pieces everywhere. It's all spread out. But to the extent of whatever I know, I am doing it. It's not that I am this thing. Anybody else has any questions? Can you stop? This you stop.